I've made a copy of ODB07 design mode and renamed this to ODB08 Delete Add Fields and Tab Order. I've opened it up, and down in our database window, we see forms, and we have our employee form. When I open that up, it shows us the form with the changes we completed in our previous video. We want to delete some objects from the employee form, so I'm going to close the form and open it back up in edit mode. I'm going to click on the address field. I'm holding down shift and also selecting the city and the state. To remove these fields, I'm going to hit the delete key, and they're gone. To fill in that empty area, I'm going to select zip, hold down the shift key and click on department and group, and use my arrow keys to move these fields over. I want to save the form. Going to close that and save our database. Opening back up that form shows us the form just as we now want it. Now we realize we really needed those fields. We shouldn't have deleted them. Let's go back into edit mode and add them back. Because we saved our document, we can't just hit the undo button. We're going to have to manually add these back in. I'm going to add some space for them by selecting our zip, department and group, and moving them over to the right. We're going to click our Add a Field icon, that's the sixth one in from the left, on our form design toolbar. Clicking that opens up our Add Field window. Here we see all the fields that we can add to this form. Even though the employee ID and name are already on the form, we can add them again if we like. I'm going to add back in the address. We can't multi-select by holding down shift, so I need to add these one at a time. Adding in city. And we have one more, the state. We can close our add field window. We're done with that for now. I want to select all three of these and line them up a little better. We've got state selected. I'm going to click on our select button and select all the fields that we just added, moving them to the left a little bit. I want to line these all up, so I'm going to right click, go into alignment, and I'll align them left. The labels are all left aligned. We want to make them right aligned. So I'm going to hold down control and click on address. Now I'm going to add shift and click on city and also click on state. Going to open up the properties box by clicking on the control icon. Here we see properties multi-selection, showing us that we have multiple fields selected. And down under alignment, I'm going to change this to right. Now that's pretty tight to our text boxes, so I'm going to use my arrow key and move it back a little bit. I also want to move in this line from our left. Bring that in a little closer. Now we want to select all the fields. So I'm going to select them all and move them more to the left so they line up a little better. It's looking better, but now our text boxes don't match up. So I'm going to hold down control and click on this phone number text box. Right click, open up the control. Here we see our properties. We've got a single text box selected, and the height of that is 0.4 inches. Let's go down and hold down control, select our address text box. I'm going to add shift and select the city text box as well as the state text box. We want to change that height to 0.4. We also want to change our border from flat to 3D. And we want to change our background color from default to gray 10%. Let's move our address up a little, as well as our city. State down, city down. So that's pretty close to what we want to see. Going out of design mode, we see our data in here. We don't see any labels because I had a label selected. Let me go back, click off everything, go back out of design mode. Now we've got our labels. I'm clicking into the last name, hitting my tab key goes to first name, that's good. Gender, that's good. Start date, end date, phone number. And then it comes over to zip, but I wanted it to go to address. Then it goes to department, then group, then address, city and state. So this isn't how we want it. Going back into design mode, to change the tab order, I'm going to come over here to this activation order icon, clicking that. We have up the phone number good. The one after phone number we want is address. So I'm going to move that up, then city, move that up, then state, move that up, and this should be good. Going back out of design mode, going to start with last name, first name, gender, start date, end date, phone number. Now we go to address, city, state, zip, department, and group. Just the way we want it. Now, I didn't point out in this tab order, it also has an automatic sort. If I click on that, it shows that we go from address to zip code to city to department. So when it comes down to where there's multiple, it would go address, zip, city, department, state, group. But I wanted it to come down and then down. So I'm going to cancel out of here. If I click on Control and the employee ID text box, bringing up that control, we see the name, FMT employee ID format. I believe this one is format because we have multiple formats. We have this as an integer, auto increment, and it's also a primary key. Coming down to the next one, we see last name says TXT, last name. For text field, last name. First name, TXT, first name. But if we jump down here to address that we deleted and added back in, it just says address instead of TXT address. The reason I'm bringing this up, when we were talking about the tab order and looking down, we have tab stop, yes, we can change that to no. Tab order, and this little dialog box next to the tab order brings up our tab order dialog box, the same one that's brought up from our form design toolbar. And here we see FMT employee ID, TXT last name, TXT first name, address, city, and state. So this is one area that our property names are used. It's probably good to have them all the same, so I'm going to add TXT, holding down Control, clicking on the city, TXT, and one more, our state, I'm going to add TXT for that one too. Now if I hold down Control and click on these labels, we see label employee ID, label last name, coming down to address. It only says address. And we added this label at the top, our heading. If I click on that, it says label field 1. That's not very descriptive. I'm going to change this one as well. I'm going to call this one Label Form Title.